College Basketball on LCTV is brought to you by Grouse Chevrolet Buick in Lincoln, your CBD store in Lincoln, and by Michelle Bauer, your country financial representative in Lincoln.
Hello, everyone. Welcome inside the Jack D. Nutt Arena. Adam Hoffman here alongside Spencer Davis. We have a men's basketball game today going up against Bethel University, a very good Bethel team. Lynx come in on this game 1-3 on this very young season for us, but Bethel, on the other hand, 13-2. They have been playing all of this time as the Lynx were sitting at home just waiting for COVID to just die down a little bit. Bethel's been playing some games. They're a good team. And Spencer, I mean, what do the Lynx need to do today to, you know, come away with a big win here for in their conference?
I mean, really, what the Lynx have to do is they have to improve on their three-point percentage. They had 20% from three last game over at St. Francis, who's another very good team. Mm-hmm. They're ranked 20th. But this is a whole different animal with Bethel. They lost by 4, I believe it was, to Indiana Wesleyan, who is the number one team in the NAIA right now. So the Lynx are really going to have to improve on what they did offensively.
Yeah, it's going to be a different game because that St. Francis team that we did play, they were a very balanced scoring attack. And, you know, a lot of their guys average double figures. But really, there's only two scorers really for this Bethel team, and that's Travion Cruz and Zach Owens. Cruz comes in averaging 21 points per game, 48% from the field, and 44 from three. But he's also averaging almost 6 rebounds a game, and he's a 6-foot guard. I mean, he's absolutely insane. And then his backcourt mate, Zach Owens, adding another 19 points per game. What do we have to do today to really slow them down?
It's going to come down to how well Lijah Donnelly and DeAndre Freeman perform defensively. Mm-hmm. It's going to come down to them on whether or not they can stop these two guards.
Yeah, they're a very capable backcourt, and you know, we've seen flashes, just those flashes of this could be a very, very good backcourt here in the NAIA, but you know, we haven't really put it together for a full game yet. You know, we saw Freeman get in the scorers table, I mean, a lot in the last game with 19 points, and Donnelly had kind of a stinker with only 9. So, I mean, it's kind of, we need them to play really good on the same night. You know, we've seen Donnelly explode for 25, and then we saw Freeman explode for 19, but they just haven't put it together at all, like, as a team. So, hopefully we can really fix that today.
Of course. And, I mean, Freeman and Donnelly, they have a good connection. We saw that in their last game. They have good chemistry. It's just about, like you said, putting it together for these 40 minutes.
Yeah, and, I mean, they started that last game against St. Francis completely different than I've ever seen them play. You know, we were very surprised of, like, they're doing a lot of ISO and, you know, getting Fuller a nice touches there at the beginning. And, you know, I mean, Fuller ended with 15 points, but a lot of those came in the first couple minutes of the game. And, I mean, this Lynx team, they were backdoor cutting. They're cutting, slashing to the basket, finding the open man underneath the basket. I've never seen a play like that. And it was great. We exploded to a very early on lead. But then St. Francis really clawed their way back into that game and eventually just took over, winning that one 80-72. But, I mean, for the Lynx, I think really just controlling the pace. Hopefully we can do that as well. And, I mean, we're done here for pregame. They're lining up here for the national anthem. So come back for the national anthem and starting lineups. You're watching Lynx basketball right here on LCTV.
I received a scholarship from Lincoln College.
I'm a dual major at Lincoln College.
I'm president of student activities. I sing alto in the choir.
I'm a dual sport athlete.
I became a leader.
I found a mentor.
I found a community.
I found my future at Lincoln College.
Many, many years ago, Grouse Chevrolet Buick in Lincoln realized that what sets it apart are the people here to help you through the purchase process and help with service after the sale. Employees with 20, 30, even 40 years of service. Here to serve you and your automotive needs before, during, and after the sale. We're proud of who we have in your corner. Grouse Chevrolet Buick in Lincoln, serving Lincoln and Logan County for more than 65 years.
The biggest change I've noticed is the reduction of inflammation throughout my whole body.
I'm also sleeping a lot better. But just for overall health, I think it's really important that people try it.
Pets aren't just pets in our family, they are family members. There's a huge difference, and to add years onto their life so that they're not suffering and they get that back, what more could you want than to spend more time with your animal?
Now let's meet the starting lineup.
That was
from
the national
Bethel.
Anthem. Now let's throw it down to Eric
today,
Kinder
starting
for
at
the
one
starting
guard,
lineups.
Number two, Zach Owens. At another guard, number three, Travion Cruz. At another guard, number 13, Garrett Sudakum. At another guard, number 22, Jared DeHart. And starting at forward, number 14, Janai Griffith. The Pilots are coached by Mr. Steve Draben. And now the starters for your Lincoln College Lynx. Today, starting at one guard, number two, Elijah Donnelly. At another guard, number 10, Rolando Brown. At another guard, number 11, DeAndre Freeman. At one forward, number 23, Tyler Clark. And at the other forward, number 32, Dijon Barney. Your Lynx are coached by Pat Lepper, assisted by Edwin McGee and Vernell Robinson.
All right, we're back here. Adam Hoffman, Spencer Davis on the call. And Spencer, a little bit of a mix-up here for the starting lineup here for the Lynx. Tyler Clark not playing, not Tyler Clark. Connor Fuller not getting the start today. Instead, Barney is going to be getting that start. I think it's really just going to kind of give us a height advantage inside.
For sure. I mean, first off, first look at our gold uniforms this season. That's always fun to see. Yep. But like you said, that fourth slot seems like it's been really interchangeable for Coach Lepp. If he wants to go with the four guard look, he starts Fuller. If he's looking for more of a traditional two forwards, he's putting Barney in, as we're seeing today.
Yeah, and especially, I mean, because Griffith is going to be pretty much their only big, so we're going to kind of get that height advantage here early on. As Tyler Clark wins that tip rather easily, it's going to be Freeman bringing the ball up here. Going to be guarded by Zach Owens, a very good defender himself. Got it to Clark at the high post. Back to Freeman. Over to Clark. Trying to give it to Clark on the pick and roll there. Don't give it to him. They give it back out to Donnelly. Just about 10 seconds left on the shot clock here. Link's got to get something going here. Pee Wee Brown stop and pop from the free throw line. In and out. That's going to be last touch there by Bethel, the Pilots. And, I mean, Spencer, they, like you said in the intro, it's they really do have that one main score. It's their backcourt, really, but mostly Cruz. So it's really going to be interesting how we're going to stop him early. They do get it into Barney. Back out to Donnelly. Lynn's got a fresh 20. That's going to be taken away there by Owens. And then Owens loses it on the fast break. That's an easy 2 points that Bethel has given up here early. They could have easily got an easy deuce there to start the game.
Elijah Donnelly definitely likes to see that. That was kind of an errant pass on his part. He didn't really see Owens lurking there. But Owens, great read. Just he couldn't really possess it all the way through.
Yeah, so Lynx, you know, a little slow start here the first possession. Let's see what they could do here. Clark has it at the high post. They're going to give it back over to Freeman. Freeman going to get a screen here from Clark. Good screen there from Clark. Opening up Freeman to the basket. Wide open for a layup there. Bethel did have no idea where Freeman was. That's going to be, we're going to bring back Cruz here the other direction. Going to kick it back over to DeHart. Back over to Cruz. Now over to Owens. Owens looking for DeHart. Down low. It's going to be picked off there by Donnelly. Donnelly up to Freeman, lobs it to Barney for the slam! Wow, what a start here for the Lynx. What a play there. Nice pass there from Freeman, finding Barney. Barney finally gets up there and finishes off a lob for us.
And it all started on the defensive end there. Donnelly with a great pickoff, and boom, off to the races, and Barney just chucks it down.
There's another almost steal there from the Lynx. That's going to be back over to Owens for a corner three. Yes. And get Bethel on the board here as well. 4-2 now, the lead here. Just about 18 minutes left to play in this first half. They do call it a 2. I thought it was a 3.
Yeah, it's a little bit tough to see sometimes with the two arcs out there to really tell where he's at.
For future reference, anybody watching, it is the white line for the college. The high school line is that black line. That was
PB Brown getting into the bat, in the lane there for an easy deuce.
Really
six
tough
to two.
Shot. Really yeah. tough shot on that part. Kind of double clutch, but still got it to go.
Here's wow, what a response there from Travion Cruz. Just a pull up three. And now Bethel drops into a little bit of a full court pressure here. It's going to be DeHart kind of just picking up Donnelly. Donnelly going to dribble out of it. It's really just kind of waste some shot clock, I believe. That's really all they're trying to do off of that. Errant pass there from Barney. It's going to be last touch there by PB Brown. So that's going to be a turnover here on the Lynx.
Yeah, Pee Wee Brown just had a it was a tough play because the ball got tipped and it went straight through his hands. If you're trying to catch something and it gets deflected, yeah. it makes it a lot more difficult.
Yeah, so it's gonna be Pee Wee Brown getting the assignment of Travion Cruz. Cruz again for three. That is good. That's why he's averaging over 20 points per game. Everybody, he's a deadly shooter from the outside. 44% on the year from three.
Just a quick trigger there. Yeah. The last two possessions, he's shown no hesitation. He catches it and puts it up immediately.
And the Lynx, they get someone. They get Barney there on the high post entry. He kind of bobbles the pass, and he's trying to find Freeman cutting, but. They do say that's last touch there by Bethel. That's maybe a little bit of a questionable call there. I thought that was for sure just off of Barney last.
The ball definitely stopped moving and kind of looked like he topped it. So maybe it was tipped. Yeah. It was a tough angle.
Maybe Barney getting the inbounds now back over to Freeman. Freeman going in the lane. No good. Gets his own miss there, and it's going to be a foul there going against Bethel.
We've seen Freeman really up his rebounding in the past few games. He didn't really start off the year strong rebounding-wise, but now he's pulling down offensive rebounds left and right, it seems like.
Yeah, that first rebound, or that first foul there is going to go on Garrett Sudakum. That's going to be the first foul of the game. That's going to be Lynx underneath their own basket once again. Probably just going to lob it in like they always do. Do give it into Clark, and it's going to be almost taken away there by Bethel, and they're going to find a cutting Donnelly who gets stripped from behind there by Sudakum. Good recovery there from Bethel.
It really looked like Donnelly had an easy layup, but great help side defense, as you mentioned there.
Yeah, maybe Donnelly was trying to get him up in the air a little bit, but just kind of didn't get it there. It's another play just absolutely red there by Cruz. That's going to be blocked there by Barney on the other end. Up the Lynx, they get the fast break going. Over to Barney for the – oh, I thought he was going to dunk it again, but no. Okay, an easy play there from Barney. That had dunk written all over it, but no. Pull-up jumper on the other end there from Owens is good. I believe that's a two. So 10-8 early here for Bethel. Lynx hanging in. Nice drive there from Freeman and one. Send Freeman to the line for one more.
This is an extremely fast-paced game. I mean, we've 20 points scored between the two teams in less than 4 minutes.
Yeah.
They're just getting up and down the floor.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of their points have come from Cruz, but I mean, for us, it's been pretty balanced. You know, Freeman got in there. Barney got a dunk. I mean, Pee Wee Brown got a nice little floater as well. So, I mean, pretty balanced scoring all around here from the Lynx so far. Free throw from Freeman, no good. Rebounded there by DeHart. He's going to bring it up the floor for Bethel. Going to try to take it himself there. Nice take there from DeHart. Going right at Freeman to get the bucket there. They're going to lob it into Barney. He's going to give it up to a guard here to bring the ball up the floor here for the Lynx.
It'll be interesting to see what the Lynx are doing because the Pilots are doing a very good job of jumping passing lanes and closing them off.
Going to need to kind of cut back door here. We do have Cruz guarding Barney, so maybe get Barney down in the post. Barney going to take a three from the top of the key way off. That one's rebounded there by Sudakum. And here is Owens' floater over Barney, and that is good. And that's going to be a timeout. Coach left here early. And we're going to take a break as well. So 15:35 left in the first half. You're watching Lynx basketball right here on LCTV.
Building relationships, supporting the community, and service. These are the things Country Financial stands for. More than just an office you pass by driving through town. Neighbors who lend a helping hand and support the fabric of our community. Contact your local Country Financial representative, Michelle Bauer, today at 211 South Main in Lincoln. Call 217-735-9705 to talk about the things that are important to you and how we can help you protect them.
And we're back here at the Jack Dionne Arena, 14-10. Lynx are trailing here with 15:35 left in the first half. Big start here for the Lynx. I mean, already 10 points on the board. Had a huge dunk early on. What are you seeing from the Lynx at the beginning of this game.
We're seeing a lot of great transition offense by the Lynx. They're really getting out and going when they get steals. And then defensively, they've done a good job of getting back transition, but big-time threes by Cruz have really propelled the Pilots.
Yeah, so it's going to be Donnelly here looking for Clark underneath. Clark going to have to just body up Griffith and take it up. No good. It's going to be last touch there by the Pilots. I like the move there from Clark. It's got to fall for him at some point.
Yeah, I would have liked to. It sets up his other arsenal of moves here, though. He can go to that spin move now that he's set up going to his right with that hook shot, and now he can go to his left, maybe get a dunk.
Yeah, and Griffith is a big body as well, so it's going to be a tough battle here for the big man here. I mean, it's a lot of – they have some size coming off their bench as well. Bethel does, so, I mean – and Donato, for us, is also back from injury. So it's gonna be a battle all day. And this is definitely could be a statement victory for the Lynx if we can get it going here today. That's not a good start there. It's a bobbled pass there by Freeman, taken away by Zach Owens. And it's going to be a foul on Freeman, just preventing that open layup on the other end.
You know what I think is interesting is they have Cruz guarding Dejon Barney defensively.
Yeah, I noticed that earlier, too. It's kind of different. I would imagine Barney would like to post up a little bit, but Cruz is a big body, and he definitely could hold his own. That's going to be a travel there on Cruz. So it's going to be a turnover here on Bethel.
One of my favorite things to see from veteran guards is just kind of showing their teammates, hey, this is what you got to do instead of making that kind of mistake with the travel there. And Cruz did a great job of just kind of like getting with his team.
Yeah. So here is Barney now on the wing waiting for that screen from Clark. Going to give it back up to Freeman. Freeman going to try to go on his own here. Going to just decide to take the pull-up jumper. No good. Up to Zach Owens in transition. What a pass there from DeHart. That was just a full-court heave.
That was a 70-foot pass and was right on the money.
Yeah, that was what a pass there from DeHart. So 16-10 now. Lynx got the ball. It's going to be Pee-wee Brown trying to shake and break on DeHart off the glass and good. Banks are open on a Friday. And that's going to be another deuce here for Pee-wee Brown. Give him four on the night. Bethel on the other end here. DeHart trying to shake. Going to get Donnelly kind of on his heels a little bit, and it's a pull-up jumper off front rim. That's going to be Freeman on the other end muscling his way into DeHart there for the deuce to cut it to a two-point game. Now 16-14. Lynx are still trailing.
Great little spin move there by Freeman.
Trying to find Griffith on the roll, and I believe they're going to get a foul there on Griffith as well. And now
technical foul assessed.
Yeah. They're going to say when Griffith fell down, he kind of took Pee-wee Brown's legs out. Or no, he took Freeman out. And then when Pee-wee Brown was coming over to help Freeman out, they said he kind of tripped him. So it's going to be two early fouls, I guess, here on Griffith.
Yeah, and that's big to get that kind of a big body out of the way for the Lynx. It opens a lot of things up for their offense, the Lynx.
Yeah, that's going to be Nick Pluta and Wesley Burst checking in for Bethel after this first technical free throw, I guess. Yeah, they do give two fouls on Jenny Griffith. So it's going to be Donnelly going to shoot a technical free throw here, and we do get the ball as well.
Yeah, I mean, that's a big foul to pick up there. Obviously, you don't want to pick up a foul about 80 feet from your own basket. It's kind of the cardinal sin of basketball is to pick up a foul that late, and then getting the technical right after was not a good play.
Yeah, so it's going to be two free throws here. And if it's two free throws, did they call it an intentional foul instead? Or did they call it, because if it's a technical foul, it really just would have been one free throw, right?
I believe in college you do get the two shots for technical.
Okay. Connor Fuller also checks in along with Nick Cohorse for the Lynx. Going to give a breather to Clark and Freeman.
We really haven't seen Dejon Barney and Nick Cohorse on the floor at the same time. I'm kind of interested to see the kind of dynamic they have together.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a different look. Both lefties and both can kind of stretch the floor out just a little bit, so it's going to be a different look here for the Lynx. Looks like Bethel kind of dropped into a zone as well. It's kind of like a switching man zone, so it's a different look here for Bethel. Lob it, trying to lob it up to Barney. It's a good bump there from Wesley Burse underneath to prevent that lob from happening.
Oh, it was great defense. He just made sure that he didn't give up baseline so that Barney could lurk for that oop.
Yeah, Coach Lupp definitely not happy after that one. It's kind of one of those passes where you know it's not going to be there, so why try to force it? So here is Owens on the other end. Over to Burse. Burse goes into the lane and goes all the way around the rim and in. So 18-15 here, lead for the Pilots. Just under 13 minutes left to play in this first half. Now swinging out to Barney, swinging over to Cohorst. Cohorst looking to give the ball up, gives it over to Pee Wee Brown. And give it back over to Donnelly. Donnelly looking to go inside. Pull-up jumper, no good. Rebounded there by Owens. He's going to push the pace here for Bethel. Going to find Pluta in transition back out to Cruz for three. Yes. Good extra pass there from Pluta.
Yeah, and Cruz 3-for-3 now from downtown. He's shooting the lights out.
He's one of the best scorers in NIA for a reason, and he's definitely showcasing what he can do here early for Bethel. Fuller finds a cutting Donnelly, blows the layup. Rebounded there from Sudikum. That's going to be up to Owens. Now over to Pluta. Pluta back up to Cruz, and Cruz going to get called for another travel there. That's going to be two early travel calls here on Cruz. Romeo Parker checks in for Sudakum.
You see that travel called a lot, especially when shooters are about to shoot and they pump fake and then drive instead.
Yeah, right on the catch, they get them. Usually they're moving their feet before they start dribbling, trying to drive in. 21-15, just about 12 minutes left to play in this first half. Brown gives it to Fuller. Fuller bobbles the pass. Seems like we're having a lot of trouble catching passes here early on. Brown going to take a contested three, no good. Rebounded there by Nick Pluta. Now Pluta going to catch it in transition over to Parker. Parker in the short corner dribbles it out, going to give it up to Owens. Going to get a screen here from Pluta. Owens back out to Burse for three. No good. Long rebound out to Pee Wee Brown, who tries to shovel pass off to Barney, who gives it over to Maris for three. Maris from the corner. Get him on the board. Not guarding Owens here in transition. Owens going to try to answer. No good. Rebounded there by Romeo Parker. And then it's going to be a foul on the play as he's driving to the basket. Lynx wanted to travel, but there's clear contact there. That's why he kind of shuffled his feet like that.
Going back to that Maris three right there, that bobble by Barney might have worked out for the best.
Yeah, it did. So Clark and Freeman check back in. Cohorst takes a seat. Pee Wee Brown takes a seat for the Lynx. Also, Zach Owens going to take a seat here for Bethel.
It seems like the Pilots are not letting their team go without Owens or Cruz on the floor.
Yeah. That's DeHart there on the inbounds pass. Going to take a quick jumper, no good. That's going to be in the hands of DeAndre Freeman. Freeman going to get a screen here from Clark. Just going to have to kick it over to Fuller, trying to get the offense in motion here for the Lynx. Fuller now over to Maris. Over to Freeman in the corner. Lynx look a little lost here on the offensive end, not looking where to go. Maris going to take a three, no good. Tipped out by Tyler Clark, but right into the hands of DeHart.
Yeah, the ball got a little stagnant there. There weren't a lot of guys moving off ball.
Here's Travion Cruz now, going to go up to DeHart. Going to get a double screen. Now over to Romeo Parker. Parker gives it up to Pluta. Pluta trying to back in, and that's going to be an offensive foul there on Pluta. Good defense there from Connor Fuller.
Yeah, it seems like he forgot that Connor Fuller is one of the best in the business at drawing charges.
Yep. I mean, as soon as that arm extends a little bit, man, it's going to be an offensive foul most likely.
Yeah, I mean, especially when it's a larger guy on a guard.
Yeah, definitely. And, I mean, that's definitely what the big guys have to worry about. They cannot extend that arm whatsoever. It's automatic offensive foul pretty much. Freeman kind of mishandled the ball, so they're going to reset here for the Lynx. Lob it into Clark. Clark, post hook good. And I like how he stopped and did a little pivot there before he took that little jump hook.
Oh, it was excellent. Great way to stop your momentum, reset, and then get an easier shot.
Cruz on the other end, make it 4-for-4 on the night. 24-20 now for lead for Bethel. That's good. I believe, yeah, that's the fourth three-pointer there for Cruz as well. It's going to be a jump ball. on the other end, good defense there by Cruz. And just more than just an offensive player.
Oh, for sure. And you look at, like, just at stats, and you're like, all right, 21 points per game, that's solid. And then you see it, and you're like, wow, okay, yeah. This guy can fill it up.
Yeah, I'm assuming that 21, he can go a lot higher than that if he wants to, and especially if he's already hit four threes early on in this first half. Cruz gets a screen there from Pluta. Pluta off the pick and roll. That's good for the bucket.
And Cruz, while he is a great scorer, he's also great at getting assists to his teammates.
Yeah, he's looking to pass as much as he can. And of course, he's going to take those jumpers. There's just a smart veteran play there from Freeman, just drawing the foul there on Pluta. That's going to be his second foul. Cohorse comes back in for Barney.
And when you're trying to hedge a screen, as Pluta was trying to do there, you got to make sure that you're showing the officials your arms so you're not holding the offensive player back from where he's trying to go.
Nicoloy Bailey checks in for the Pilots. Going to take the place of Pluta. That's going to be DeAndre Freeman now setting things up for the Lynx. He's guarded there by Travion Cruz. Cruz now over to Maris in the corner. Maris, step back three. Yes! What a play there from Maris. We see that he is not just a catch-and-shoot three-point shooter anymore. He's definitely shaking it up. He can do those little dribble move step-backs as well.
Yeah, we've seen that pull-up jumper from him in the past. That's the first time he's gotten that step-back three-pointer to go.
Parker for three. No good. Rebounded there by DeHart. DeHart kind of maybe a little hesitant there with Tyler Clark roaming. Misses the layup. Freeman pull-up transition three. No good. Rebounded there by Parker. Parker going to push the pace here for the Pilots, and they're going to call an offensive foul there on Parker. Maris steps in and takes it. Maris, sacrificing the body a little bit there, getting back in transition and just stepping right in front of him.
The Lynx are just scrappy. All of their guards are just, they're willing to take those gritty plays. No one wants to take a charge. Nobody likes getting in front of a guy going full speed at him. These Lynx are more than willing to do it, it seems like.
I think we're kind of taking the approach as well. I mean, let Cruz have his, let Cruz have his points. So no one else is going to get an easy basket on us. I think that's kind of how we have to play. Donnelly, pull up three, no good. That's going to be rebounded there by Burse.
Great transition defense by Donnelly. He never let Cruz get behind him.
And we're going to see Donnelly front Cruz, trying to lob it into him now. Good defense there from Donnelly. Cruz now in the post. Fall away jumper rattles around. Rebounded there by Tyler Clark.
Tyler Clark's rebounds have looked way better today. He has not dropped it below his chin, I don't think, once. And as a result, he is always really getting those rebounds.
Yeah, Fuller there. Shot fake goes right around him. And that's going to be an easy deuce there for Connor Fuller. 26-25 now. Lynx cut it to one. Parker gets it on the inside now out to DeHart. DeHart for three. No good. Rebounded there by Tyler Clark. And like you said, Spencer, gets that rebound, keeps it up high. Doesn't want those pesky guards there for Bethel to come in there and take it.
I'm sure Coach Lepp emphasized that in the game plan that, hey, Cruz will take it out of your hands.
Yeah, it's going to be an errant shot there from Blake Maris. That's going to be no good. Rebounded there by DeHart. DeHart going to decide to pull it out here. Suffocating defense there from Fuller. And then Fuller's going to pick up a foul. It was good momentum there from Fuller, but just kind of got a little too aggressive there.
Yeah, I think he was trying to get that five-second count with the closely guarded, and he just went a little overboard at the very end, causing that foul.
That's going to be Freeman, Barney, and Pee-wee Brown back in here for the Lynx, and Zach Owens going to come back in here for Bethel. Here's Sudakum back over to Owens. Owens gives it out to DeHart. DeHart going to stop and pop from the free throw line. Good. And Freeman going to give it up to Donnelly here in transition. What a play there from the Lynx off of a made shot. Going to get a wide open layup here for Donnelly. There's a timeout on the play. 6:55 left to play here in the first half. You're watching Lincoln College basketball right here on LCTV.
Many, many years ago, Grouse Chevrolet Buick and Lincoln realized that what sets it apart are the people here to help you through the purchase process and help with service after the sale. Employees with 20, 30, even 40 years of service. Here to serve you and your automotive needs before, during, and after the sale. We're proud of who we have in your corner. Grouse Chevrolet Buick and Lincoln, serving Lincoln and Logan County for more than 65 years.
And we're back here after the timeout, 28-27 here, 6:55 left to play in this first half. Lynx looking good so far. We're really trying to run and transition on this Bethel team.
We talked in the pregame how Bethel is a great team, but if the Lynx can put their all of their pieces together, they can hang with these great this Pilots team, and yeah. Right now we're seeing that.
I mean, yeah, we've talked about it a lot. Like we're 1-3, but all of those games were very close. And it's like we've only lost to great teams as well, so that's definitely something positive to look at for Coach Lepp. That's going to be Owens driving in. It's going to be a foul there. And I believe it's going to go on Donnelly.
He's trying to plead his case there, kind of say, hey, I'm getting held yeah. as well.
He's saying that he's hooking him, and that's why it looks so bad. That's going to be the first foul there on Donnelly. Four fouls here for the Lynx, and no.
Good help.
DeHart has
defense.
It now. DeHart, free throw line jumper. Called it signature move. He's gone to it plenty of times here, early here for Bethel.
And it keeps working. Keep going to the well if it's still drawing water.
Cohorse going to get called for the charge there. And, I mean, talk about minimal contact on the charge. He Euro-stepped right around him, barely bumped shoulders with him.
I don't even think he bumped shoulders. It looked like he bumped hips. Very. But, I mean, I guess the defender was set.
He was there. Yeah,
but
he was there.
Usually you don't see a charge call when the offensive player goes around. I'd rather see that as a no call.
And yeah, Owen's going to split the double team. Goes right up on Barney. No good rebounded there by Donnelly. Donnelly going at Owens now. Nearly takes it away. Now Donnelly finds Freeman over in the corner.
We see a lot of contact on those transition plays yep. by both teams.
Pee Wee Brown has it now. Spin move gets stripped there by Owens. Last touch there by Pee Wee Brown. Great defensive play there from Zach Owens.
Yeah, Owens and Cruz are a dynamic backcourt, both offensively and defensively. Cruz is kind of the standout steals-wise with two a game, but Owens obviously displaying he can also take the ball away if he needs to.
And Donato Pekak checks in for the Lynx for the first time. And believes the first time since the first game that we've played because he was injured. So it's good to have another big body out there for the Lynx that we can interchange. Here's Sudakum now. Wraparound pass there to Burse. No good. Rebounded there by Barney.
Barney did a great job of going vertical on that attempt there to block.
That's going to be kind of a hesitation move. Gives it over to Pekak. Pekak floater. No good. Put back there from Barney. Also no good. And into the hands of Zach Owens. Owens now over to DeHart, guarded by Donnelly. Back up to Owens. They're going to set something up here, high pick and roll. It's going to be Bailey going to be picking up the offensive foul there on the screen.
Freeman's taking some blows today.
Yeah, Freeman has been taking some hard screens, some hard hits going to the basket. So it's going to be Lynx ball on the sideline. That's the first foul there on Bailey.
Only down three with five yeah. minutes left in the first half. That's big.
Yeah, 30-27, like Spencer said, 5 minutes left. We have very much the chance to shake up some standings here in the NAIA. Bethel has received some votes to get into that top 25, and really just we're looking to get some footing here on some rankings.
Really build some momentum is what they're looking for. Yeah. This would be a signature win if they can continue playing this well.
Pekak kicks it over to Donnelly. Donnelly back over to Pekak for the floater. No good. Tip back up by Pekak. He gets his own miss again. Goes up once again. Keeps tipping it up like he's Dennis Rodman. Trying to get that basketball back out to Donnelly for three. No good. And then Pee Wee Brown comes up with it. Nice play there from the freshman and gets it to go. 30-29 there. I love the effort on that play there from all of the Lynx, just showing so much heart trying to get that basketball.
Oh, it was just absolutely, I'm going to get this basketball one way or the other. We started with Pekak, and then we got to Pee Wee Brown. Awesome plays.
Turnaround jumper from Cruz there, no good. Rebounded there by Pekak, and he's kind of bringing some energy here for the Lynx is when he comes in.
For sure, and the bench is some great energy over there as well.
Now back up to Pekak at the top of the key. He's going to go right to the lane, and the finish there from Donato Pekak over Bailey.
The bench is loving it. Donato is a great guy on the bench, providing energy when he was out with his injury, and now the bench is giving him some props.
They give it down to DeHart, who kicks it over to Bailey. Bailey on the inside, no good. It's going to be a loose ball picked up there by Freeman. Freeman. Going to just try to take it himself. Dump off pass there to Barney for the finish. 33-30 now. And what a run here from the Lynx. It's going to be a timeout called. And we're going to take a break as well. You're watching Lynx basketball right here on LCTV.
The biggest change I've noticed is the reduction of inflammation throughout my whole body. I'm also sleeping a lot better. But just for overall health, I think it's really important that people try it.
Pets aren't just pets in our family, they are family members. There's a huge difference, and to add years onto their life so that they're not suffering and they get that back, what more could you want than to spend more time with your animal?
Back here at the Jack D. Nutt Arena, Lynx hold on to a lead, 33-30, 3:22 left to play in this first half. And Spencer, I mean, we're seeing this Lynx team really get out and try to run a transition today.
Yeah, they're doing a phenomenal job in transition. That comes down to those guards that we talked about, Donnelly, Freeman. They're getting rebounds or they're getting outlet passes, and they are gone.
It seems like the Lynx just came out and really want this game. And, I mean, this, like you said, this would be the biggest signature win for us on the season. Yes, it would only be our second win, but, I mean, to take out a team that would be getting votes to get into that top 25 would be huge for this Lynx team.
Especially considering Indiana Wesleyan, the number one team in NAIA right now, they only beat this Bethel team by 4.
Yeah, I mean, that proves to you how good Bethel can be. And, I mean, the Lynx really trying to kind of suffocating them here early. I mean, yes, it is a very, very, very close game, but, I mean, making them very uncomfortable.
You said it best, I think. You were like, the Lynx are saying, we'll let Cruz get his, but we're going to lock everyone else down,
yeah.
And that's been great. Griffith is back in the game here for the Pilots. We'll see if that changes anything for them.
Yeah, he picked up 2 early fouls with that technical foul, so he's back here. Going to get a screen there, and then they're going to get a quick foul there, I believe, on Donato Pekak. I mean, that's kind of what he's – it's a good play. I mean, it's a tough foul call there for Donato. But, yeah, he's going to take a seat here, picking up his first foul. I mean, how else do you really show on that on the pick like that? It's big.
Yeah, it's just that Cruz came off that screen so quickly, it looked a lot worse than it was.
Owens on the finish, no good. Rebounded there by Griffith. Griffith goes up and 1. And that's going to be a foul there on Tyler Clark.
Lincoln College basketball on LCTV and WLNX is brought to you by Grau Chevrolet Buick in Lincoln. Since 1953, Grau has been a family-owned and operated business committed to Lincoln and Logan County. Grau offers new and pre-owned Chevrolet, Buick, and Cadillac vehicles, and they have a complete service department that will be there for you long after the sale. Grau Chevrolet Buick at 1905 North Kickapoo Street in Lincoln and at grauinc.com.
Griffith does knock down the free throw there to tie the ball game up. Just under 3 minutes left to play here, 33-33. That's going to be Donnelly up top the key, going to give it over to Clark. Clark looking for Barney underneath. Barney got that mismatch floater over Cruz, no good. I like the move there from Barney, just needs to fall for him.
I just like the post up there. There is a significant height advantage.
Cruz, another 3. Give him 5 threes in this first half.
And 5 for 5.
5 for 5. He has not missed a 3-point shot yet. He's missed a few turnarounds. I mean, how do we stop him? I mean, yes, it's good if we're just going to let him have his and all, but, I mean, he's already got 15 just on threes alone. He's scored a lot underneath. I mean, I don't really want him going for 60 points on us.
I mean, it's very hard because his threes that he's hitting are when he's open. And they're just off of screens. He's just got such a quick trigger. I think the Lynx are going to have to probably face guard him and just not let him touch the ball, which is a lot easier said than done.
Yeah, it's gonna be tough. Maybe I think do what we've been doing here to finish out the first half, then maybe throw a different defense at him to start the second. You know, kind of confuse him just a little bit.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see that zone that Coach Lepp likes to use to kind of mix things up.
Yeah, maybe a box and one on Cruz, and maybe have Freeman or Pee Wee Brown guard Cruz, just face guard him. Don't let him really catch the ball.
Anything to just slow him down and get him out of his rhythm.
Yeah. Here we go. Back over to Pee Wee Brown, guarded by DeHart. DeHart, I believe, is going to pick up a foul here. That's going to be a 1-and-1 here. Pee Wee Brown going to go to the line.
The Lynx have done a great job of emphasizing that huddle together after fouls.
I think that's definitely what Coach Lepp wants this team to do. They want to get closer together. I mean, it's definitely we want more of a team because, I mean, we don't have that one guy that we can really go to just score all of our points. But so we really need to win as a team. So, I mean, just getting all the guys on the same page is going to do wonders for this Lynx team.
And it was fun to see practice right before the game. These Lynx were kind of doing a walkthrough, and they were laughing. They were having fun. And that's what you want to see. They looked like a team.
Yeah. Two free throws good there from Pee Wee Brown. Cut it to a one-point game now, 36-35. Just about 2 minutes left to play in this first half. DeHart has it now, guarded by Donnelly. DeHart gets a screen there from Griffith. DeHart is just going to pull up, jumper, no good, rebounded there by Barney. It's going to be Donnelly here trying to push the pace here for the Lynx. Donnelly just takes it himself. Like you said, I mean, just what a strong take there from Donnelly, make it 37-36. That's going to be Cruz on the other, or Owens, I should say, on the finish, no good, rebounded there by Tyler Clark. Good job contesting there by the big man. Over to Pee Wee Brown in the corner, no good. That's going to be, I believe, last touch there by Barney, but they're going to have a little bit of a discussion here.
It might have bounced off of the backside rebounder.
Yeah, they're going to give it Lynx basketball here. Underneath their own basket, shot clock did not reset, so 21 seconds left. The minute 31 left in this first half. Broken play here for the Lynx, just got to get something go. And then it's going to be Sudakum comes up with a steal and then an immediate foul there to prevent the layup.
What I think is interesting is every time the Lynx get a quick basket in transition, the Pilots try to do the exact same thing, and typically it ends up in a miss. But then it's a very transition-based game today.
Yeah, we're just trying to get whatever we can. That's going to be Donnelly's second foul. Fuller's going to come in for him. It was a broken play there from the Lynx on the inbounds. Just miscommunication, kind of two guys ended up in the same place and then just had to throw it in just to prevent the five count.
Yeah, we saw Donnelly and Barney bounce into each other on the beyond the arc right there, and Donnelly was a little upset with Barney.
Sudakum knocks down the first one. That's going to be Bailey coming back in here for Griffith. I think we need to attack Bailey here on some of these final possessions here. He's definitely kind of the third big in the rotation here for Bethel.
Yeah, I'd like to see Clark get some more touches. He hasn't really seen the offense or the ball on the offensive end. Great job at rebounding today, but he just hasn't really touched the ball as an offensive threat.
Yeah, he got that one touch and he got the post hook and it was a decent shot, just it didn't fall for him. So they find Freeman underneath their own basket. That's a high percentage look there from DeAndre Freeman just going right at Owens.
That's kind of his shot. He gets the ball in that low block. It seems like it goes in every time.
Surprisingly a very good post player for how small he is. And he's very smart with the ball, just trying to get people in the air. That was a behind-the-back pass, believe. It went off of a foot and then saved there by Pee Wee Brown. Now over to Freeman. Freeman's going to get fouled on the attempt. That's going to be another foul going against Bethel.
Great hustle by Pee Wee Brown there. Like, a lot of guys will let that go out of bounds. It was going to be, well, actually, bounced off of Clark's foot, I think. He leapt up for that block, and the pass went right off of his foot.
Yeah, it's surprised. He's not trying to kick it, it doesn't count as a kick, I guess. So, I mean, it went off his foot. Pee Wee Brown, great hustle play, getting the save. And Life Granville is going to check in for Bethel.
Pilots trying to inject a little bit of life into their team here.
Yeah, you had to do it. If people are wondering, his name is Life Granville. And Spencer had to make the horrible pun, so we're here. That's two free throws there from Freeman are good. 41-38 lead here for the Lynx. Just under 50 seconds left to play in this first half. Another three there from Cruz, and he's hit it again.
Big-time steal by DeHart.
Yeah, DeHart again. Give Bethel the lead right back. 43-41. Bethel in charge here. Cruz, 6-for-6 on the day from three.
He's Lynx just getting that three-pointer whenever he wants.
Yeah, Lynx got to get a good basket here. 25 seconds left to play in this first half, and then they throw it out of bounds. Miscommunication there between Pee Wee Brown and Barney.
Coach Lepp just seems frustrated because it seems like his team, they keep doing these great three possessions, and then they just have an error that you're – it leaves him very confused.
Yeah, it's definitely – it's such a, like, deflating when it's a kind of a turnover like that, because Bethel now has the upper hand because they have a little bit of momentum on here. I would imagine they're going to hold for the last shot here with 10 seconds left to play in this first half, and I'd imagine Cruz is going to take that shot.
One would think, especially the way he's shooting today.
Cruz is going to take a three. Yes, 7 for 7 on the day for Cruz. And talk about a guy just going off. I mean, wow, what a shooting clinic he's putting on here in the first half.
That's got to be some kind of record, like most attempted threes in a half and not missing.
I mean, that's just very good basketball from Cruz. I mean, what a shooter he has been. I thought going in the game, I was like, he's a big guy. He's just going to get in the lane a lot and get a lot of fouls called for him. But no, it's the three-point shot that's kept them. I mean, other than him, I mean, we're doing a great job. It's 46-41. A dude's hit 7 threes on us. So, I mean, we're not playing bad.
No, no. It's just come down to those errors that we talked about. That turnover with in the backcourt after that three-pointer that Cruz made. And then turning it right back over, that was a massive momentum swing. Yeah. You could see it because we were up three. He makes the three tie game, and then this little 5-0 run here to really end the half.
Yeah, and I think it's definitely we're going to have to do something for Cruz here in the second half. I think the box and one might be a good look for us because, like we said, I mean, the other guys aren't really hurting us that much. It's really Cruz that is really keeping them ahead in this ball game. So we're going to take a break here for halftime, come back in about 10 minutes or so for some stats and analysis. We're watching Lincoln College basketball right here on LCTV.
I received a scholarship from Lincoln College.
I'm a dual major at Lincoln College.
I'm president of student activities. I sing alto in the choir.
I'm a dual sport athlete.
I became a leader.
I found a mentor.
I found a community.
I found my future at Lincoln College.
If you love them enough to suck the snot out of their nose at 4 a.m., then surely you'll check nhtsa.gov/the right seat to make sure they're in the right car seat.
I don't remember how it started.
Go to that.
Our back and forth. It always came back. You probably don't remember what you told me.
That was perfect.
But I heard every word.
Since I was young, my friends told me, and my coaches, that I'd be a good coach someday. It was my senior year and it was crunch time. And Lincoln College with a sports management degree, and it just like something clicked.
I've just always had a passion for sports. There's a lot of opportunities out there within sports management.
It's for anybody that has a love of sport in general, and also from the standpoint of administration, but more importantly, just the love of the game and also the opportunity to work with others. The opportunities that they get at Lincoln College, they won't find as many other places from the, you know, having the opportunity to get hands-on experience, you know, throughout the college itself as we transition to four-year athletics and in our community.
I coached a summer travel baseball team for 3 years, which I'm now the president of. So the goal is to be an athletic director. They organize schedules. They work with coaches. There's an athletic director at all levels, junior high, recreational programs, high school, college.
The types of jobs available to our students when they graduate here cover the whole sport arena from youth sports all the way up to professional sports. And there's a lot of different disciplines that you could find yourself working in also.
I've helped with college, higher education, I've helped with high school and junior high, and all those experiences helped me get the positions that I'm able to get now. even before graduating college.
Day after day, I learned something that I could use when we're in a board meeting or for a parent meeting or our flyers for tryouts, stuff like that. Just all the classes that I've had, I never felt like I didn't learn something that would help out with where I'm at now as the president or being the head coach of other schools in town.
Leah, did you put a new dent in that?
This one? No.
Were you texting and driving again?
Yes.
Hi, Leah.
Hi, Dad.
Sorry about your bumper.
This is Creekside. This is part of Lincoln College. We use this for our science courses. We'll bring our students out. They get the chance to learn about different topics in the classroom. And then for their laboratory exercises, we'll bring them out here. In the real world, you're not going to be in a classroom behind a desk reading a textbook. You're going to be in the field, in a creek, in a forest somewhere, actively testing different hypotheses, looking about different topics. So it's important for us that students get hands-on experience doing field work and not just being told about it in a classroom.
Last semester I was taking botany and environmental biology, and I really fell in love with the biology course, and I knew that we had some great staff, including Dr. Osler, so that really compelled me to stay here. I'll be getting my associates at the end of this semester, and then I'll have another 2 years for my bachelor's in biology from Lincoln College.
I was in a biology class and I absolutely fell in love with everything about it. I loved the research. I loved coming out here, doing things hands-on. I learned more. I can see it. I can feel it. And I can bring out my kids, like I said, and they're learning along with me.
Like, every school has a lab. Not every school has this wealth of resources to come to. We can do research projects. We can explore nature. We can learn about the different wildlife. It is very important to me.
This is the story of a boy who didn't talk for a long time. The boy liked things to always be the same. Any changes would scare and upset him. The unknown was an unfriendly place. The boy was very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where they couldn't get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. He wasn't trying to be mean, it just made him feel uncomfortable. Sometimes he would flap his arms again and again.
One day I found out I have something called autism. My family got me help. Slowly, I found my voice and learned all the way I could live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Your girls have been with you through every moment of your life. They were with you when you felt unbreakable, and with you when you had your heart broken. They were with you when you shared your love with the world. And with you when she became your world. They're still with you right now. But how well do you know them? You don't know what
I mean. It's not my first time bartending, so.
It's a sausage party in here.
It's fine. I'm very familiar.
Yeah, because you're a sexy girl, Sam. Last thing,
yeah,
is that the music, when Momo kicks it into high gear, is gonna get a little bit loud in here. Mm-hmm. So your customers are gonna have a hard time hearing you. So you may want to.
What?
Make sure
they don't
get too close.
When people refer to the FAFSA, it's the free application for federal student aid. FAFSA is gonna determine your eligibility for your loans, which is based on your grade level, as well as your need base. So Pell Grant, SCLG, as well as Illinois State Map Grant. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to fafsa.ed.gov. It was called the free application for a reason. Be careful of anything that's trying to charge you. If the student worked, they want to have their financial information for that tax year, as well as their parents' tax information, or have the parents with them so they can put in their FAFSA ID and password. You can transfer that information directly from the IRS website. If you don't have that information, you'll want to have your parents' 1040, which is the form they use to file their taxes. It's always going to be better to use that tool. First of all, if you get selected for verification, you will not have to provide any tax documents to us to verify that the information on the FAFSA is correct, because that information came directly from the IRS. And when you complete the FAFSA, you're going to want to make sure to include Lincoln College in your FAFSA by using our school code, which is 001709. That will ensure that we receive your FAFSA, and then we can determine your eligibility for Illinois State Map Grant or SEOG. We have an e-verification site in which a student can just log in remotely. They don't have to bring a bunch of papers into us and go. We don't have to go through all those papers. What they can do is they can verify their FAFSA on that site. So they set up a username and password. They'll be able to e-sign the verification worksheet, and then any documents that they need to provide to support their income, they can upload from a mobile device. I always want students to start as soon as possible, because then they can determine their aid. And if they are not fully covered, they can look into other options to cover that balance that they have, whether it be a private loan, or they can put a plan in place to save some money, do a work study. It just gives you more time to really put a plan in place just in case you do have a remaining balance for the next school year.
I'm gonna be honest, I don't find it that hard, because the first time I did it, of course, it was hard. The first time is always hard, but if you keep up with everything and just do everything on time like how you're supposed to do it and before the deadline, you'll get everything through and just faster and easier. So it wasn't hard for me, no.
Applying for financial aid early ensures that if you're eligible for certain grants or other scholarships, you get them because your application gets in first. Also, staying in contact with your financial aid office ensures that any documents you might have that are outstanding, they can give you information on those and you can get those in, so your financial aid will be complete.
The biggest part of a student being successful a lot of times is that financial stress. So if we're able to ease that stress a little bit, student can focus more on their schoolwork, becoming acclimated to the school, getting into programs, rather than worrying about how they're going to pay to go to school.
Building relationships, supporting the community, and service. These are the things Country Financial stands for. More than just an office you pass by driving through town. Neighbors who lend a helping hand and support the fabric of our community. Contact your local Country Financial representative, Michelle Bauer, today at 211 South Main in Lincoln. Call 217-735-9705 to talk about the things that are important to you and how we can help you protect them.
The biggest change I've noticed is the reduction of inflammation throughout my whole body. I'm also sleeping a lot better, but just for overall health, I think it's really important that people try it.
Pets aren't just pets in our family, they are family members. There's a huge difference, and to add years onto their life so that they're not suffering and they get that back, what more could you want than to spend more time with your animal?
And welcome back inside the Jack Dean Arena. About 2 minutes left here in the halftime. We got some stats for you guys. I mean, the real story here is Travion Cruz, 21 points in that first half, and all of them came off of three-pointers, 7 for 7 on the day. And, I mean, just talk about lighting it up. I mean, he can't miss.
The dude is shooting the lights out. It's going to be interesting to see what Coach Lepp does to combat this, because really it's not like the 7-3 that Crew hit.
Was ridiculous.
Oh, it was ridiculous. It was a fall away with a guy in his face, and he still made it, which is not something you want to see as a Lynx player, because it just means the guy's locked in no matter what.
Yeah, but other than that, though, they got two guys with 8 points, and then a lot of scoreless players there the first half there for Bethel. And for the Lynx, we got DeAndre with 10, and the only person that has not scored for us is Nick Kohorst. And he played five, or he played about 6 minutes there in that first half. So, I mean, and Nick's really not out there to score either. He's really out there to play some defense, maybe get a few garbage points there off of offensive rebounds. But other than that, we're very balanced scoring here in the first half.
Yeah, and even when you go down the list of rebounding, we have 4-4, 3-3, 3-1. Everyone is contributing, which is what you want to see as a team that is built on a sense of camaraderie and not a star leading the team.
Yeah, and I mean, something that needs to improve here in the second half, 11 turnovers there for the Lynx in that first half. Freeman had 5 and Pee Wee Brown had 4, so that's definitely a majority of the turnovers coming from the two guards in the backcourt, so we just got to clean it up here in the second half.
Yeah, and I'll be interested to see how Elijah Donnelly responds. He was held to 2 points in that first half. I expect him to play much better. I expect him not even to play better. It wasn't that he played poorly. It was just he wasn't getting his shot.
Yeah, and he didn't really shoot that much, and, I mean, he definitely could have made a lot more shots. I mean, he took 2 threes, but definitely both of them were very good looks, and they just didn't fall for him. So they will fall for him later on in this game, I'm sure. So start of the second half here, 46-41. Lynx are trailing. They need to make a big stand here in the NAIA for a big win here. It would be huge for us. And we're just going to start the second half off here with Freeman. Going to kick it over to Pete Brown. Going to give it into Clark. Clark. Jump hook, yes. Get him started here in the second half. He races down the floor. Good start here for the Lynx in the second.
And we talked about that towards the end of the first half. We said that they needed to get Tyler Clark some more touches offensively. And right there, he just displayed he's got touch.
That's going to be a foul going against DeAndre Freeman, trying to force Cruz off the three-point line. They do make him go inside there, but it is going to be Freeman picking up his second foul. Going to lob it in here to Griffith. Give it back over to Cruz. Cruz is going to take a jumper. Yes. That's his first shot that he's hit inside the three-point arc, so maybe he's going to switch it up here in the second half.
He's got a very smooth shooting stroke. Like, it looks pure. There's nothing herky-jerky about it.
I think we need to attack him here on the other end. I mean, we got Barney with a distinct height advantage over Cruz. Backdoor cut there from Donnelly. That was a great pass there from Pee Wee Brown. Finding Donnelly on the finish.
Donnelly does an excellent job of moving off ball, especially with those backdoor cuts.
Because he kind of lulls you to sleep and then just cuts right behind you. Clark, good contest there. To be out of bounds, last touch there by Bethel.
Clark does such a great job of altering shots. Like, he doesn't block a lot of shots, but he does a great job of just positioning himself to where the shotter or the shooter has to alter what he's trying to do.
Yeah, and just because you come away with a lot of block shot doesn't make you a great rim protector per se. I mean, just altering shots, like you said. I mean, just making them shoot very poorly from the field down there would just be huge in their second half. Barney now sees the mismatch, goes right at him. Good move and good finish. Just couldn't finish it.
Yeah, I'd like to see him keep going back to that, though. It was just didn't roll in for him, but I think next time it goes in.
Owens there. Missed three, and then Donnelly finds Freeman in transition, and he has to corral himself, go back, and gets the finish there, 48-47. Good pass there from Donnelly, good finish there for Freeman.
Yeah, and it would have been it would have looked a lot better if
caught it Freeman, in stride.
Exactly. Kinda. Freeman kind of bobbled it at the end, but still finished at the end. That was good.
And Griffith looked like he took about 14 steps there getting to the basket. He comes up shaken up. As you know, missed shot there. As Clark and Barney were just swarming him underneath the basket.
I was glad there wasn't any foul called because it sure looked to me like Griffith hooked around somebody. Like there was a distinct elbow that jumped through the group.
Yeah.
So I'm glad there wasn't any sort of call there because, I don't know, I thought there should have been an offensive foul before, but at the end of the day, Lynx get the ball back.
Yeah, and Coach Luck definitely wanted to travel there as well because he did take a few extra steps there trying to pivot. No, he's going to stay in the game, though. He came up a little shaken off of the ankles. Maybe we need to try to attack that. And it's going to be Donnelly now. Donnelly back over to Barney. Barney going to give it back over to Freeman. Gets a screen from Barney. And Freeman just going to take a pull-up three. No good. Offensive rebound. Tyler Clark, who's been coming up real clutch lately with those offensive rebounds. Donnelly now over to Freeman. Now over to Pee-wee Brown. Brown going to the lane. Passes it right to Burse, and Burse now in transition. Blocked there by Barney in the recovery. Barney again with that chase down block. I believe that's his second or maybe even third of the game. He's so good at coming from behind like that and getting just perfect timing.
Oh, he's just a pure Picasso in that chase down block game. Just an absolute masterpiece right there.
Going to give it into Cruz. Cruz back out to Burse. Burse going into the lane, knocked away by Barney, and comes up with it. Is Donnelly now over to Freeman. Freeman gets hit on the layup, and no foul, no nothing. That's going to be back up to Burse the other way. Gets the layup to convert.
I sure thought that Sudakum was standing out of bounds and that ball hit him, but I guess not.
Yeah. And I thought Freeman kind of got hit over the head when he caught the ball underneath the basket too. So, I mean, it's definitely – we need to just get some momentum back on our side here for the Lynx. Kick it over to Freeman now. Freeman back over to Donnelly. Donnelly for three, no good. A lot of contact on the shot. Didn't really give Donnelly room to land there. It should be a double dribble there. And now they're finally going to call a travel. I mean, DeHart, he bobbled the ball, kind of reclaimed it, started dribbling again, got away with the double dribble. Then they eventually called the travel on him, trying to give it up.
Yeah, that was a really bizarre play, especially because the bench of the Pilots acted like he broke Barney's ankles, but I don't know. Yeah. It didn't really.
Barney was diving after the ball.
Yeah, and he didn't have possession of the dribble anyway.
Barney has it now, top of the key. Maybe shuffled his feet a little bit there, got away with one. Here's Freeman getting to the basket. Blocked there by Burse. Good defense there from the Pilots. They're going to push in transition. And then Cruz throws it right out of bounds looking for DeHart. So, I mean, the Lynx, I mean, if they're turning the ball, not turning the ball over, but if they're taking rough shots, and, I mean, as long as the Pilots are kind of giving it right back to us, I mean, we could stay perfectly in this game, but we got to limit those mistakes and try to capitalize on theirs.
Yeah, turnovers are really why the Lynx are still down at this point. It's just you can limit those turnovers and keep forcing turnovers as a defense. This game is going to start getting out of hand in favor of the Lynx.
You know, swinging over to Freeman. Freeman going to take a three. No good. That's going to be last touch there from Barney.
I like the aggression that Clark and Barney are showing going after those offensive rebounds in this half.
Fuller and Maris come back in here for the Lynx. Maris had six in that first half off of two threes. And Fuller was a little bit quieter. He did hit a couple, his signature free throw line jumper. But I think maybe put him on Cruz. I think that'd be a good look here for the Lynx.
For sure. Fuller's a great defender, so it'll be interesting to see how they attack it.
And they're going to get a basket there in the foul there for Griffith. Wasn't a ton of contact, but definitely some. I thought there was maybe some contact there on the ball. That's what it sounded like to me at least, but definitely maybe some body contact kind of swiping over, and it automatically looks a little worse when he's kind of swiping. Pee Wee Brown checks out again. That's going to be Cam Gardner checking in for the first time here in the second half. He did not play at all in that first half, which is very surprising. Gardner, usually one of the first guys off the bench here for Coach Lepp. But he's also a guy that can bring some intensity on the defensive end as well. Gardner has it now here in the corner. Back over to Fuller. Up to Clark. Over to Maris. Maris kicks it over to Fuller. Fuller for three. No good. Rebounded there by Griffith.
That was a good look by Fuller, and because of Blake Maris's ability to drive, they had to really help off of Fuller, so I like that shot there.
DeHart's going to try to kick it over to Burse, and it's going to go out of bounds. So once again, Bethel gives it right back up to the Lynx, so 53-47. Lynx just hanging in there. Have been pretty quiet and ice cold here to start out this second half. Just got to get something going for us.
This is where the Lynx really have to attack. They need to go after it right now.
They need to just try to get in the lane, get an easy jumper, or just an easy finish. Maris tries his little step back. Barney now going to the basket, and he's going to get fouled. He's going to go to the line for two.
Lincoln College Basketball on LCTV and WLNX is brought to you by Michelle Bauer, your country financial representative in Lincoln. Country financial agents are members of their local communities, neighbors who lend a helping hand to local causes and community projects. And when it comes to solving the big challenges of tomorrow, you can start with simple steps today with personalized insurance and financial services that can have an impact on your family's future. Michelle Bauer, your country financial representative, is located at 211 South McLean Street in Lincoln or at 217-735-9705.
Nick Pluta checks back in here for Bethel. Barney knocks down his first free throw. He has one more. Second one good there from Barney as well. So 53-49. Lynx hanging in. Just about 15 minutes left here in this second half. Nice cut there from Burse. And they're going to call a foul there. Very similar play that we just saw on the other end there from Barney. That's going to be Burse going to the line for two.
Yeah, and I mean, what the Lynx did great there is obviously the Pilots had a turnover on their last possession and the Lynx got points. And that's what they have to keep doing is when there are turnovers, they need to capitalize. And then they need to get stops.
Wesley Burse first from the line is good. I mean, they were very similarly built as a team. I mean, we're very guard heavy, got some shooters, and we got some size inside, but not a lot of post presence, I would say, and we got some athletes as well. I mean, very similar teams. But just Bethel has been doing it for a lot more games than we have this season.
And it's starting to show a little bit.
Yeah, Clark comes up with the ball after Barney just about traveled with the ball. That's going to be Fuller here, pull-up jumper, no good. Rebounded there by Cam Gardner. It's going to be a jump ball. And it's going to be Bethel basketball. But, I mean, good effort there by Cam Gardner, just attacking the offensive glass.
Gardner does a great job of finding that kind of backside. A lot of times his offensive rebounds come off of those short shots that bounce to the other side of the rim, and he always seems like he's there.
Yeah, loose ball there, picked up there from Cruz. There's another foul called. That one's going to go against Maris, trying to guard Zach Owens. Owens, a little pull-up jumper there, and it's going to get fouled, so he'll go to the line for two.
Owens is a good free throw shooter with 78% from the line, so not really the guy you want to send to the line in this event, but he's not the best shooter on the team from the free throw line, so hopefully that can help out a little bit.
And he's been very quiet here. He's 19 points per game, and, I mean, he's just been a little quiet there in the first half. He had 8 points. That first free throw was good by him. Donato Pacat comes back in for Tyler Clark. Owens has one more from the line. Owens, second free throw, no. Gets handled the rebound, Barney and Pacak did. And Barney, I believe he's going to pick up a foul here. That's either going to go on him or Pacak, and this Nick Pluta just attacking the basket.
We've seen this now in most of the Lynx games that they played this year is they have this really bad lull at the beginning of the second half.
Yeah.
They don't come out of the locker room on fire a lot, and it leads to leads growing.
They get very lackadaisical because, I mean, that first half we played very well, so they're feeling pretty confident coming out of the second, and they kind of ease off the gas pedal a little bit. Second free throw there from Pluta, no good. It's 57-49. Bethel still on top. And a kick it back over to Gardner. Gardner looking for somebody. Gives it up to Maris. Maris coming off a screen. There's a little fall away jumper off glass and good. Nice move there from Blake Maris.
Extremely tough shot going off of his off foot.
And here's another offensive foul here on, I believe it's going to be on Pluta. That's going to be his third foul.
I think so, that's his second on moving screens as well.
Yeah, I know he picked up that offensive foul on Maris early on, and then, I mean, that one as well. I mean, if all of your fouls are coming off of nothing defensively, I mean, that's something you got to look out for because you don't want to pick up a silly one. The jumper from Fuller, no good. Rebounded there by Barney. Back out to Fuller. Going to set things up for the Lynx. Maris, stop and pop, no good. Rebounded there by Fuller, and then it's going to be picked up there by Maris. Maris from the parking lot, and good. Swish bomb. What a play there from Maris. I mean, to have, I mean, just the confidence to pull up like that. I mean, he had lane, and he just decides to pull up instead. Cruz tries to answer. He's human. He missed a three-pointer. And it's going to be Maris coming up from the parking lot once again. No good. Rebounded there by Barney. Barney just takes it out. I mean, if Maris would have made that, I mean, the roof would have blown off this place. I mean, Marius is feeling it if he's taking those.
Well, I mean, it looked like he slid into like third base there to grab that ball, hops back up, and then drills a three. And I really like that shot attempt there. He's feeling it. You might as well.
Yeah.
Not sure if I really liked that travel call, though.
Yeah.
I thought Barney let go of it, but maybe he'd taken a couple of steps.
Before, yeah.
Yep.
I mean, definitely. I would have just preferred Barney to just go up right after the shot. And here's Zach Owens on the other end going to pick up a foul. I believe Blake Maris is going to pick that one up.
And that was a huge three-pointer for the Lynx. It got everyone going again. You saw the bench kind of come to life, get excited again, and now they're only down three.
Yeah, 57-54, 13-13 left in the second half. A little stoppage of play here. I believe the refs kind of talking things over. Where to set the shot clock, they do settle on 24 seconds. So here's Owens now. Going to give it up to Cruz. Cruz now going to be guarded there by Maris, so they're probably going to try to attack him. Sudeikum now over to Cruz. Gets a mismatch once again here with Cam Gardner. Drives in, stop pop off glass, no good. Barney kind of comes up with it, and then it's just going to be a jump ball. I mean, the shot clock should have reset because it did hit rim, but they do call a timeout on the play. And 57-54, and we're going to take a break as well. 12:46 left to play here in the second half. You're watching Lincoln College basketball right here on LCTV.
Many, many years ago, Grouse Chevrolet Buick and Lincoln realized that what sets it apart are the people here to help you through the purchase process and help with service after the sale. Employees with 20, 30, even 40 years of service. Here to serve you and your automotive needs before, during, and after the sale. We're proud of who we have in your corner. Grouse Chevrolet Buick in Lincoln, serving Lincoln and Logan County for more than 65 years.
And we're back here after the timeout, 57-54, 12:46 left to play in the second half. Lynx trailing. That's going to be Bethel underneath their own basket. Going to give it in to Zach Owens. Owens gives it up to Sudeikum.
Maris playing some tenacious D out there.
And Lep just getting his team in, or getting the bench involved, gets them all fired up as well. DeHart going to check back in for Bethel.
And this is a really, it seems like an extended break here for Donnelly and Freeman. We haven't seen them out on the floor for a while, but this group is holding its own.
It's holding its own. Maris is kind of going off just a little bit, give some life to us. And Cruz goes to the bench here for Bethel. Be hard enough to Pluta. That's going to call a blocking foul. Should be on the floor. Or no, it's going to be a one-and-one situation here for Nick Pluta. He was passing out of that, so it's definitely not a shooting foul.
And that's big that the Pilots are already in the bonus here with 12 and a half minutes left in the game. That's a problem.
Yeah. Only three fouls for Bethel, so we really need to make something happen here for the Lynx. First one good there from Pluto. Pluto, no good. And it's kind of rebounded there by Barney. And it's going to be a foul there going against Sudeikum. So pick up a foul right there, make it 14 fouls. For Bethel.
Yeah, I think Barney thought it was on him.
Yeah, Barney thought it was
frustrated.
Maris now going to give it up to Fuller. Fuller going to set things up here for the Lynx. And Tyler Clark is looking to give the ball up, trying to get someone in here. Up to Gardner, back out to Maris. 10 seconds left to play.
Really trying to get it into the post.
I give it over to Barney now. Barney just going to have to make something happen. Jump hook, no good. He's right there on those attempts every time he takes them. Just can't come up with it. Maris comes away with the steal, going to kick it up to Fuller. Fuller with the layup on the other end. Good play there from Maris in the defensive end and picking it up. Over Fuller. Got the steal over to Maris for three. Yes! Give the Lynx the lead right back. 59-58. What a swing of events. Beautiful play there from Fuller coming up with that steal. And now Bethel needs a timeout.
Big time three.
What a swing of momentum there for the Lynx. Maris has come in once again and just brought just fire off of this bench for us.
Yeah, it really seems like he's become the spark plug for this Lynx team.
The microwave score.
The microwave. Whenever he gets going, this team gets going. And yeah. This is now, what, the third or fourth game where he's had a big-time three that really gets everyone going.
Yeah, I mean, he had a couple of them down in St. Louis when he had 25. But, I mean, when he's hitting clutch threes like this and just having the confidence in the shot to pull up and transition.
Well, yeah, and it was a great – let's start with the defensive play he made first. He got that steal, and then he got it up the floor. And then we saw Fuller with a great defensive play just to harass the ball handler seemingly out of nowhere and still get that and then get it to Maris, who just drills it.
He stepped right into the shot. It was a great pass from Fuller, and just right in the shooting pocket, right for Maris to just stroke it.
And, I mean, Maris has such a great form. Like, when he caught that, it was pure. It was right in the shooter's pocket, as we like to call it. And then he was just – it was in.
I mean, Maris – I mean, it's been Maris' three-point barrage here in the second half. It hasn't been Cruz as much. He's been very quiet here in the second half. Only – I believe only 2, maybe 4 points. So, I mean, compared to his first half, that's very quiet. But
they've been throwing Fuller at Cruz a lot in the second half.
That's definitely the best matchup for him, I think. Because Fuller is just, he doesn't quit. I mean, he's going to do whatever he can.
Evidenced by that steal he just got down here.
And now we're going to do Fuller on Owens as well. So Fuller, just a versatile defender. DeHart going to be guarded by Maris. Now back over to Owens for three. Yes, answers it right back to give Bethel the lead once again.
Fuller kind of got stuck down there in the post. He wasn't able to get back to his man.
61-59, 11 minutes left to play here in the second half. I'm going to get a handoff here to Gardner. Gardner looking to give it into Clark. Clark looking for somebody. They do give it up to Maris. Maris gets open for three. No good. It's going to be rebounded there by Bethel. A lot of commotion there. It's going to be a flopping call. I don't know on who.
Maris.
Did he just try to sell the elbow there on the catch, I guess?
I think so. He went down after he shot that three.
That's what it was. Because I was wondering about that as well. I think he just really trying to...
I think he's trying to show that, hey, I got to have some room to land here.
Yeah, room to land. That's really what it is now. I mean, it's not so much that you hit the shooter. It's you got to give him a safe place to land.
Kind of the Kawhi Leonard rule.
They give the ball into Burst, and he kicks it back out to Owens now up to DeHart. DeHart's shot, no good. Picked up there by Burse. And then Clark comes away with the block, and then they're going to give a foul there on Tyler Clark. And, I mean, it looked pretty clean to me. But, I mean, maybe it's the angle. It looked clean from up here. But
and usually it's with the body. Typically guys are good about not smacking the opponent's arm, but it's usually the hip, the chest that gets into the shooter.
He misses the first free throw there. Pee-wee Brown checks back in for Gardner, who played some pretty big minutes here in the second half for LEP.
Gardner did a great job of doing his job, which is just it's to get boards, move the ball, be a dribble threat,
and
play good defense.
And now we're going to go to a different look here. Tyler Clark going to take a seat. Nick Cohorse coming in for him. And also Romeo Parker comes back in for Bethel. Over to Barney now, over to Fuller. Fuller looking to shake and bake like he always does. Pull-up jumper, no good. Rebounded there by Owens. Owens going to get it taken away there by Maris. Maris thought about pulling the three there on that pretty much one on four. Maris for three, no good. Rebounded there by Barney. Go up, big man, and gets it to go. 62-61 now. With 10 minutes left to play here in the second half, Lynx staying in this one.
Barney's just done an excellent job of always being in position to rebound today. Even when he's not getting those rebounds, he's always super close.
Owens there on the jumper, no good. Pee-wee Brown comes away with a strong rebound over Griffith. Good play there by the freshman.
Griffith kind of looked like he thought that Pee-wee went over his back there, but I think that it was just good positioning.
Now there's going to be a foul on the play. Definitely Connor Fuller kind of out of control a little bit there at the end because he had to jump to pass it, but I mean maybe that's why he kind of getting held. That's going to go on Zach Owens. That's his second foul. Here comes Travion Cruz back in for Bethel along with Life Granville for Bethel. It's going to be DeHart and Sudakum taking a seat.
And we talked about the Lynx having kind of a slow start at the beginning of the game, but or at the beginning of this half. They've really come back into it.
And to give it in to Barney, now over to Cohorse. Gives it Brown in the corner. Brown guarded by Granville. Kind of shakes him a little bit. Going to give it into Barney, who has Parker guarding him. Barney again with that lefty jump hook. No good. He tries to get his own rebound.
He just keeps leaving it short. He just needs to put a little bit more muscle into that one.
So it'll be a turnover here for the Lynx. Granville takes a seat, and DeHart comes back in for the Pilots. DeHart now, pull-up jumper. Yes, that's a nice pull-up jumper there from DeHart.
He's money. I think most of his shots have come from inside the arc, and it's usually that pull-up jump shot.
Yeah, he's not just a three-point shooter. I mean, he definitely can make those, but his bread and butter is just like Fuller, just that pull-up jumper from the free throw line.
He does a great job of selling that three-point attempt.
Pee-wee Brown on the attempt, goes right back up, and not good for the and-one attempt, but he does get fouled in the process.
Lincoln College Basketball on LCTV and WLNX is brought to you by your CBD store in Lincoln. CBD is found in industrial hemp plants and has been featured in news reports as offering many health benefits. Your CBD store, the largest hemp retailer in the U.S., is now celebrating its grand opening in Lincoln. They are located at 520 Broadway, just off the square. Your CBD store offers SunMed and Sunflora CBD products, including oils, edibles, topicals, and more. And they have staff on site to answer any questions. Your CBD store is open Tuesday through Saturday, 10 to 6, and Sunday and Monday, 12 to 4. Now offering curbside service. Your CBD store, just off the square on Broadway. Also, find them on Facebook.
One of two there for Pee-wee Brown. Blake Maris does take a seat. DeAndre Freeman comes back in for him. But yeah, memorable minutes there from Blake Maris. We'll probably see him later on in this game.
Yeah, they just love putting Maris in to kind of give the Lynx some life.
That's going to be tipped away. And it's going to be in the hands of Pee-wee Brown. Now over to Fuller. Fuller gets hit on the layup attempt. It's going to be a foul there on DeHart. It's a little strange that Fuller on the left side decides to, you know, go kind of up and under the basket instead of just taking that nice, like, easy lefty layup.
Yeah, I think that he thought that DeHart was going to undercut him a little bit harder, which he thought that the up and under would work better. But, I mean, he's still at the line for the chance for the two.
Yeah. And Fuller knocks down, or he misses that first one, I should say. Used to say, and Fuller knocks down the free throw. He's one of the better free throw shooters we got on the team, but no good there on the first one.
Everyone's human. We've seen Cruz, who we thought was just a three-point hitting robot.
Yeah. That's going to be another free throw there for Fuller. That's knocking down to a one-point game now. 64-63, 8 minutes left to play in the second half.
The Pilots are really trying to get it into the post to Griffith here, and they just can't. Cohorse doing a great job of fronting.
There's Romeo Parker now. Gives it up to Cruz. Cruz jumper, no good. A lot of collision there. I believe it's two guys on the same team. They give it to Pee-wee Brown in transition. Brown, good stop and pop from three. Yes! Nice swing of events here for the Lynx. Get them to reclaim the lead, 66-64.
Starts with good defense. The Lynx are turning good defense into offense. Cohorse did a great job of staying vertical right there. Griffith offensive rebound, though.
Yeah, nice. It comes away. Pee-wee Brown gives it up to DeAndre Freeman. Freeman going to drive, try to go, take it himself. No good there. And Cruz comes away with the rebound as well. Pee-wee Brown comes away with the big block, and they're going to say it's body contact before the shot there for the foul. But I mean, what a play. I mean, still, he's preventing the layup as well. So I mean, that's just a great heads up play there from the freshman.
No easy baskets is the phrase.
Yeah.
And he did a great job of that. He made sure that there was not going to be a chance for an and one on that.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a highlight reel block, but he unfortunately got some body contact before.
He's had a couple of those now. Last game he had a great block, but again, caught body.
Yep. First one from Cruz, or from Owens there, no good. Parker going to take a seat. So we see Dacom coming back in along with Wesley Burse.
Lynx are just hanging in there. This is much better performance than I expected. I did not think that we'd really be this. I didn't think we'd be leading at this point.
Yeah,
in the game.
Bethel is a great team. So I mean, this is definitely one of our biggest challenges yet. And I mean, we're sticking into this ball game. That's really, we're the team that never goes away, really. Even though we have that 1-3 record, it's just we've been in every single game we've played.
And like you said, really, there's a good case for us being 4-0. It's just it came down to some turnovers, some unlucky shots not going down. Good drive there by DeAndre, though, drawing the foul.
Yeah, Freeman going to make Trevon Cruz pick up a foul. It's going to be his second. Pluta comes back in. That's going to be DeAndre Freeman going to the line for a 1-1.
Lynx have been doing just a phenomenal job of just getting to where they want to be.
Yeah, I mean, DeAndre's always been really good at that, just attacking, just trying to get to the basket. Sometimes you'd like to see him kind of maybe just take a pull-up jumper, but other times, I mean, you just want to see him get to the line. That's what he's really trying to do.
And the Lynx now in the bonus, so that'll be good to see.
Yeah.
Unless, of course, you don't make your free throws.
Yeah, we got to make the free throw in order for us to be really thankful to go to the line. So picked up by Sudakum. Going to kick it over to Burse. Burse attacking the lane. Going to be a foul there on Barney.
He got him with the chest there. He kept moving towards the shooter as the shooter was going in. That's a good call.
Yeah, Barney really just needs, he knows he's going to flash the basket like that. Just need to beat him to the spot and just try to get position and try to pick up a charge there. Only Barney's first foul, though, so that's good news for the Lynx.
That allows him to keep challenging these shots aggressively. That's probably what resulted in that foul being called, is that he knew that he had no fouls. He can kind of try to get a little bit more physical with it.
Yeah, first one no good there from Burse. Burse at the line, 6:53 left, 66 now as Burse knocks down the free throw, tied at 66 with just under 7 minutes left to play in the game. Here's Freeman now going to give it up to Cohorse. Cohorse looking to pass, gives it over to Barney. Barney, jump hook finally gets one to go. Lid is off the basket for Dejon Barney.
All that needed to happen was him get bumped farther away so he put more muscle into it.
He got that one over. That's going to be another foul, I believe. It's going to go on Pee Wee Brown.
Looked like he kind of held up the arms.
Yeah, it's going to go on Pee Wee Brown. I was hoping they wouldn't give that one to Barney because Barney was just there to contest the shot. But it's going to go on Brown. It's going to be his second.
Usually,
10th.
Usually when a driver kind of tries to put the ball up and then twists, usually it's on that guard typically that's got the hands pinned.
So it'll be Zach Owens going to the line for two. We've seen the Lynx kind of slow down just a little bit. I'd like to see them try to get back in transition. Haven't seen Donnelly either here in the past probably about 10 minutes or so. I'd like to see him get back in the game. He was just kind of that guy that was trying to get out and transition for the Lynx.
Yeah, he was doing a great job of just moving the ball, dribbling, playing great defense. It'll be interesting to see when he comes back in. I would assume he comes back in at some point.
Yeah, so it's 2-for-2 there. Good from Zach Owens. Make it 68-68. 6:22 left to play. Going to give it up to Barney now. Now over to Cohorst. Cohorst can't shoot that three, but usually does not. Barney is going to screen for Pee Wee Brown. Barney gets the entry pass, and it's going to be tipped away. Last touch there by Sudakum.
I like that try to kick there from Barney. He caught it and saw an open man and just ball got deflected.
Yeah, it's going to be a timeout, a full timeout on the play. So we are going to take a break as well. You're watching Lincoln College Basketball right here on LCTV.
Building relationships, supporting the community, and service. These are the things Country Financial stands for. More than just an office you pass by driving through town. Neighbors who lend a helping hand and support the fabric of our community. Contact your local Country Financial representative, Michelle Bauer, today at 211 South Main in Lincoln. Call 217-735-9705 to talk about the things that are important to you and how we can help you protect them.
Is that what?
And we're back here in the Jack D. Nunn Arena. 6:06 left to play in the game. 68-68 is the score. Lynx, I mean, we're trailing for quite a while there. We do come back in the game, took the lead for a little bit, mostly due to Blake Maris kind of getting a lot of shots to go for him, but he's on the bench right now. What do the Lynx need to do, Spencer, to kind of put this one away?
They got to keep limiting their turnovers. That's why the Pilots are still in this game. It's because the Lynx keep turning the ball over at really inopportune times. But they can limit those turnovers, keep getting good shots, and, again, limit fouls, because at this point, any foul they make, it's sending a Pilot to the line for two free throws.
Yeah. I mean, we haven't seen, you know, Donnelly that much here in the second half. I'd imagine that Maris is going to come back in at some point. Gardner as well has only played selected minutes here in the second half. So, I mean, we have a lot of options if we want to try to switch things up if things aren't working.
They just have to keep Fuller in because he's such a great defender.
Now on the inbounds, they're going to get Barney for a travel there. And Barney just going to kind of say, my bad. Clark going to come back in here for the Lynx, going to take the place of Barney.
The nice thing about having your big guys not in foul trouble is that you can kind of rotate them in whenever you want at this point without a lot of fear.
Yeah, so Clark will come back in, and he'll get the assignment of Pluta down low. That means Cohorse will move over to Burse, which is kind of a mismatch. Definitely Burse is a lot quicker than Cohorse on the perimeter.
Cruz and Freeman is going to be a fun battle to watch here these next few possessions.
Yeah, Freeman does a good job contesting the ball, and then
Brown got popped in the face, I think.
P. Brown got clipped going, trying to get that rebound, and he comes down clinching his mouth. Got to get the trainer out there. You don't see any blood on the floor, at least.
Yeah, just I don't know if I would assume an elbow. Typically, that's where that happens. Yeah. It looks like somebody clipped him upwards with his elbow into his nose. It's kind of how he signaled with his with the trainer. That's never a fun experience.
Yeah, definitely not. Donnelly going to come in for Pee Wee Brown. He's just going to kind of – we're going to take precaution here and, you know.
Make sure nothing's –
yeah, make sure nothing's wrong.
Yeah. Yep.
So I'm sure we'll see him back – I'm sure we'll see him back here in a few minutes. So Donnelly is going to check back in after – pretty long stint there on the bench for the Lynx.
We'll see if that makes him a little bit more motivated, kind of show, hey, I need to be in more.
Dump-off pass there to Pluta, no good. And then Clark doing a good job, trying the best he can without fouling.
He did a great job staying vertical in both those shot contests.
So it's going to be Donnelly here getting the assignment here, set things up here for the Lynx. Quickly off to Fuller, now over to Cohorse. Over to Clark in the corner. Clark puts the ball down on the floor. And Connor Fuller just going to try to do it himself here. Loses the ball. That's going to be a held ball. That's going to be Lynx retaining possession.
I like Fuller trying to call the timeout there, but at the same time, he didn't have full possession at that point. Good hustle by both teams, though.
Yep. That's going to be Barney and Maris checking back in for the Lynx. Taking the place of Fuller and Clark. So, really good minutes there from Fuller. The past about 10 minutes or so, he's just really put the Lynx on a new defensive kind of energy.
Yeah, he's just locked down the two big scorers for these Pilots.
Going to switch the basketball out here. I believe it's – maybe the basketball got a little bit of wet on it. So, new ball here for the Lynx. I give it into Maris. Back over to Donnelly. Donnelly, dump off pass there to Barney, and Barney gets the floater to go with the left hand. So 70-70 now, just under 5 left to play in the game.
Donnelly has just such a smooth change of direction there. Yeah. He can really stop and go at really whenever he wants.
So Freeman gets the assignment of Owens now this time. Good dump off pass there from Cruz, and Cruz, he gets the pass to go through to Pluta, and then Pluta, I don't know. I mean, to me, I know I'm biased, of course, but I mean, Pluta, he took a lot. Let's say he took some steps there to get to the basket before he got that shot up.
Nothing like a good couple shuffle gather steps, you know?
Yeah, it was. Yeah, I thought it was definitely a travel. That's what Coach Leff wanted, and
I guess it's what the ball wanted too.
It's what the ball wanted.
Ball
as
don't
well.
Lie.
Yeah, so Pluta misses that first free throw there. Second one here from Pluta is good. And now DeHart's going to check back in for the Pilots.
DeHart's kind of the Pilots' version of of Maris. Yeah, I mean, he's just not a three-point shooter as much. We haven't seen the three-point range as of yet.
But, yeah,
but Maris is
just the guy that could come in and just shoot the lights out for you off the bench. Donnelly now just going to attack DeHart. Goes right over him, pretty much through him for that basket. 72-71, Lynx retain the lead.
I like Donnelly going right after DeHart. They know that DeHart's out there more for his offense rather than his defense, and Donnelly knew that too.
That's going to be Maris checking DeHart on the other end. Donnelly now bigger, a better size matchup for Cruz. Pluta with the follow. What? That's a nice athletic rebound and finish there from Pluta.
Yeah, you got to make sure you box out there on that play. You don't want to offensive rebound. Good take by Freeman.
Yeah, Freeman just goes right at Owens, who does this little thing of kind of a flop there. We saw it from Mark Perdue on the other end, wanting the flop. Cruz doesn't get the layup to fall, goes all the way around the rim. And here's Freeman back the other direction. Nice scoop shot and one for DeAndre Freeman. Chance to extend the lead here for the Lynx, 76-73. Lynx going on a little bit of a run here lately.
DeAndre Freeman is in his bag right now. We saw some post moves being made, and then he just had that sweet little, I don't even know how to describe it, stop and turn and reverse layup is excellent.
He's so good at just changing tempos. Like that hesitation move is so good for DeAndre. He does miss the free throw there. Keep it at a three-point game, 76-73. That's going to be a foul there on the play. Travion Cruz going to the basket. It was all ball there on the finish bar, but we've said it all game. It's the body that gets the foul.
Yeah, and I mean, he's doing an excellent job, though, of making sure that that basket does not go in for the end one, which is it's something that it's hard to teach, like foul, but make sure that, like, if you're going to foul, to make sure you block the shot, which is much easier said than done, but Barney does a good job of that.
And he knocks down the first one there. And then Sue Dacom's going to come in for Owens. He's been out there for a pretty long time. Second one, no good. Picked up there by Pluta. And it's going to be stripped there by Maris, but picked right back up from Burst. And there's going to be another foul there. It's going to go against Barney. It's going to be his third. The second foul in less than 10 seconds.
Yeah, we kind of saw him check in the other day and pick up those two fouls in the first half early. I mean, it came down to – that's a big – the fact that he didn't have a foul coming into the second half, he's been able to pick up three now. That's huge. If he'd come into this half with two fouls, one foul, it's a very different game.
Yeah. So Burse doesn't hit the first one there, 76-74. Lynx just trying to hang on to that lead. 3:25 left to play in the second half. Second one up from Burse and good. And Griffith's going to come back in for Pluta, who's played some very good minutes here for the Pilots, getting a lot of clutch offensive, just more possessions for the Pilots.
He's just done a great job of keeping the offensive possession alive for the Pilots, which eventually leads to points.
Yeah, so it'll be Freeman going to do that signature set there for Coach Lepp, going to give it up to Cohorst. Had Donnelly kind of cutting there in the back door, about had him, going to give it back up to Freeman. 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Donnelly had the jumper, going to take it himself, though, underneath. Goes right over Burse for the layup. So Donnelly having some life here late in this second half.
I just love seeing guards catch the ball, put the ball on the floor, and then kind of like tuck it in like a running back.
Yeah.
Still take those two steps and then lay it in.
That's going to be DeHart giving it up to Sue Dacom. Back over to DeHart for three. No good. That's going to be picked up again by DeHart. Back over to Burse, and they're going to call a foul after the shot. And it's going to be an and-one opportunity, and Barney's going to pick up his fourth foul now. He's kind of one of those plays for Barney. Just got to let him have it. Don't want to do anything silly.
Yeah, he just came under the basket. I don't think he really meant to run into him.
No, he definitely didn't.
He jumped towards the basket, and Barney was standing there at that point, and just an unfortunate foul, really.
Yep. So here's one more here from Wesley Burse, and no good. And Barney's going to come away with the rebound up to Freeman. Lynx trying to push.
I like a controlled push that they just did right there.
They
made sure that they got across half court, but it also sets up their offense a little bit quicker.
And trying to get the defense a little bit on their heels, see if they're going to bite a little bit at that transition. They're going to give it over to Maris now. Maris trying to find Barney underneath. They do finally give it to him. Barney just going to make a shot for seconds left on the shot clock. Donnelly comes away with the offensive rebound and a putback. Coach Lepp's going to take a timeout here with a minute 58 left to play. So we're going to take a break as well. You're watching Lincoln College Basketball right here on LCTV.
Whew. The biggest change I've noticed is the reduction of inflammation throughout my whole body. I'm also sleeping a lot better, but just for overall health, I think it's really important that people try it.
Pets aren't just pets in our family, they are family members. There's a huge difference, and to add years onto their life so that they're not suffering and they get that back, what more could you want than to spend more time with your animal?
And we're back here in the Jack D. Nutt Arena. Just about 2 minutes left to play in the second half. Lynx holding on to a three-point lead, 80-77. I mean, really, this game deserves to come down to the wire like this for how close it's been this whole entire game, Spencer.
Yeah, both teams have just been going to absolute war. We've seen some great plays by both. Maris hit those deep threes to begin the second half, really keep the Lynx into it. Because that early second half, it seemed like it might get out of control.
Yeah, I think it got up to maybe 8-9 points. Mm-hmm. I mean, and Maris just caught us back in with those. I think he had 3 three-pointers. It was clutch. It was definitely clutch Blake Maris. And we're just going to have to see how the defense can lock down here. We've really kept Cruz quiet in the second half. And we're going to have to keep doing that or else we're going to give up this lead again.
And, Adam, they brought back Connor Fuller back into this game, and I assume that is to check Cruz.
Yeah, I think so. And also we have Pee Wee Brown back in along with Tyler Clark. So starters minus DeJon Barney out for the Lynx.
And this is a larger lineup for the Pilots right now, so Pee Wee Brown's going to have to play larger. And it looks like they're in a 2-3 zone.
Yeah, we're going to go back into a zone here, kind of try to confuse the Pilots just a little bit. They're kind of trying to get anything they can. They do give it to Cruz in the corner there. Thought about the three. Now back over to DeHart. DeHart up to Burse. Jumper no good. Rebounded there by Donnelly. Donnelly going to give it up to Freeman.
Lynx did a great job of rebounding. A lot of times when you see teams switch to zone suddenly, they don't rebound super well because they forget to box out. Yep. That time, great box outs.
We played man pretty much the whole game, so I mean we should know by now we gotta pick up someone on the glass. Gonna get a screen here from Clark. Gonna go right at the basket, does Freeman, and then it's gonna be no good. Picked up there by the Pilot. It's gonna be DeHart going in transition up to Griffith. No good on the two, and it's going to be picked up there by Connor Fuller. Good hustle there from the Lynx. And Fuller smartly backs it out, and he's going to pick up a foul there. I believe it's going to go on DeHart, and it does. Lynx going to the line for two.
It's going to come down to free throws. If the Lynx can make free throws, they're going to win some games. We talked about it in the first four games. If they make more free throws, they win their games.
I mean, going back to the first game that we had, we went into overtime with Kokomo, and if all we got to do is knock down one more free throw, like we said, I think we missed 11 in that game. First one from Fuller is good, 81-77 now, 53 seconds left in the game.
That was a huge free throw, putting your team up by two possessions now. This is another big free throw. The five-point game is monumental this late.
Another one from Fuller is up and good, and Coach Lepp is going to take a full timeout as well. So we're going to take a break. And you're watching Lincoln College Basketball right here on LCTV.
Building relationships, supporting the community, and service. These are the things Country Financial stands for. More than just an office you pass by driving through town. Neighbors who lend a helping hand and support the fabric of our community. Contact your local Country Financial representative, Michelle Bauer, today at 211 South Main in Lincoln. Call 217-735-9705 to talk about the things that are important to you and how we can help you protect them.
Get a free throw. And we're back here in Lincoln where the Lynx holding on to an 82-77 lead. And, I mean, 50 seconds left in this game, Spencer. I mean, what do the Lynx need to do here to just close this one out?
Adam, it's going to come down to free throws. If they can keep making free throws, they're going to be all right. And they need to make sure that they keep playing defense. Just because you're winning by five does not mean you can just take breaks, especially with a guy like Cruz who can knock down a three seemingly whenever he wants.
Yeah, we were just talking about that. over the break there, Spencer, but I mean, Cruz has been very quiet here in the second half. I think maybe two, maybe 4 points. But other than that, it's not the first half. It's not like the first half he had with 21. So, I mean, he's definitely due to hit a big shot for Bethel. So he's gotta check in, make sure he does not do anything late in this one.
And they're definitely going to throw a guy like Fuller or DeAndre Freeman, one of their better defensive players, just to make sure he doesn't feel too comfortable out there.
Link's got a little bit of a press there, just kind of wasted some clock. They're going to give it back up to Cruz. Cruz guarded there by Freeman and Pee-wee Brown, I believe they said.
Inadvertent whistle, I believe.
Yeah,
I think the official thought that
he called a timeout, yep. I think. And he was like, I didn't call a timeout. So they're going to give it in to Cruz, guarded by Freeman. Freeman going to get screened. Over to DeHart. DeHart going to take a pull-up jumper. Yes, he's been their saving grace here in the second half. Is DeHart just keeping them in this ball game. 82-79, 33 seconds left. We're going to stay right here, talk this one out, Spencer. This, I like that we're not giving up a three, but at the same time, you know, we can't give up that easy of a shot.
And right. I mean, you don't want the three-pointer to go up, so I'm glad that Fuller at least ran him off the line, because a free throw, if you can make both of those, that same. Equates yeah. that. You don't want a three, which does bring you within one.
Yeah, and we did just bring in Blake Maris as well, so we're going to get all of our free throw shooters out there and try to get something to happen here. I mean, they don't need to foul. That's the thing. I mean, they don't need to foul, but I mean, they'll only leave them about 3 seconds left if they don't choose to foul. So they're just going to have to force them into something tough if you're Bethel, and if we start getting some clock really running off, you're going to have to foul.
I would expect them to try to get a steal in the backcourt. They'll put a press on, I assume, because then if they do, of course, get the ball across half court, there's about 20 seconds left on the shot clock and about 23 on the game clock, and that's when you can foul.
Yeah. I mean, you just got to – if you're Bethel, I mean, you're just looking for a steal on the inbounds and just trying to get an extra possession. I mean, you're looking for the steal first, but that foul is definitely the last resort.
Right.
I mean, you got to stop the clock somehow. Don't let us run it down to 3 seconds left.
And the Lynx have to be careful not to go into these trap zones we've talked about before. And those are right around half court. It's those corners. So usually the Pilots are going to try to let the Lynx get across half court and then force them into that kind of triangle, Bermuda triangle, if you will.
Lynx go all guards. We ran this play last game where they have to come across and they do a kind of a double inbounds pass. Fuller gonna step through the double team there, but Coach Lepp is gonna take a timeout. It's gonna be a full timeout, and we're gonna stay right here. I mean, that's a good play there for the Lynx getting across half court. That's all they needed to do really right there, and now it just comes down to Bethel and how hard they're gonna play this.
Yeah, I'm not sure if I completely liked that timeout there. I felt like Fuller had options to pass out of that.
He just pivot through the double team, but I think as soon as that double hit, Lepp definitely was like, okay, let's just make sure. Yeah, just got to make sure. You don't want anything silly to happen where you just kind of force a turnover like that.
And they are in the position now where there will be a foul given out almost immediately upon anyone catching the ball. They just have to be careful not to. Cruz has done a couple of times where he's sagged off to the point where the Lynx think they have a guy open, and they are not open because Cruz has great recovery speed. So they just have to be careful to make intelligent passes here.
Yeah, Bethel had 6 steals in that first half. I mean, they're definitely looking for one right here. I mean, that's definitely what they need. And, I mean, if they do get a steal, I mean, you just got to go down and make the quick two and then just try to get something or just immediately foul.
Yeah, I mean, the Lynx, like you said, just be calm, stay available, make sure there are multiple options open, make sure you don't go into these Bermuda triangles near half court.
Yeah, stay away from the half court line, especially away from the corners, like Spencer said. Get the ball in the middle of the floor, get it into a guy like Fuller, who's a pretty good free throw shooter for us, about came away with a steal right there, did Bethel, and now Pee-wee Brown going to pivot through the double, and he's going to get fouled.
Very close there.
Very close. And Brown will go to the line for 2 shots, double bonus.
As soon as the shot clock turns off and your team is up by like 3, that's when you're like, all right, this is real. This is the real deal. This is crunch time.
Yeah, this is definitely crunch time right now here for the Lynx.
Brown is a solid free throw shooter.
Yeah, I was hoping you wouldn't say that. As soon as you say something, that's the broadcaster curse. You can't say anything with the free throw.
Yeah, I mean,
he's solid. Yeah, he's solid. I mean, we just need him to hit one here to just kind of put this game in, you know, in a stronger control here. Second one is good there from Pee Wee Brown.
And that's it's not the ideal trip to the free throw line in that position, but it's certainly better than going 0 for 2.
Yeah. I mean, it's still good to get one. Like you said, Barney checks back in for Maris. Link's going to get a little bit of pressure here. And Barney, nice contest there. And they get a rebound there for Zach Owens as well. Back out to Burst for three and hits it. And it's going to be a timeout. So 83-82 now off the Burst three-point attempt. I mean, the guy really hasn't hit one all day. I mean, that's if you're going to leave anybody open, I'd rather it be him. But, I mean, he hits it in the most clutch spot he could.
Yeah, I mean, you can't be super upset with that because, like you said, he hasn't shot a three. He hasn't really shot all day besides the free throw line. So, I mean, you're going to let him shoot. Unfortunately, he goes in. But, again, that's why that free throw was so big, because you still are in the lead.
I mean, of course, we would have liked to have two made free throws. So when we do get fouled, we have a chance to make it a four-point game. But, I mean, still forcing it to three would be nice.
And Coach Lepp needs to make sure he emphasizes the fact they have no timeouts. We do not want a Chris Webber situation where you get trapped and call a timeout that you don't have, which results in technical free throws.
Yeah, and definitely, I mean, who do you want to get the ball here to shoot the free throws? Is it Fuller or is it, you know, Donnelly or Maris as well is out there?
I mean, Coach Lepp's done a great job of making sure that his best free throw shooters are out there. I think a guy like Maris, who has shot really well today, should be definitely in consideration. It comes down to, again, make the smart pass. Don't make some sort of sketchy pass. And make sure you just, if you see one open guy, you have to pass it to the first open guy. It doesn't matter where he's at because there might not be another open guy.
Yeah, I mean, it's got to do, like you said, I mean, no room for mistakes right here. I mean, you cannot let anything bad happen. And he's got to give it into a hands of a good free throw shooter and then just hope for the best, try to make both. So 11 seconds left, 83-82. Lynx have the lead. And Fuller kind of slips there on the inbounds. They're going to give it into Donnelly, back into Pee Wee Brown, now over to Maris. I thought Pee Wee Brown did come away. I thought he did pass that one out before he got fouled, but they are going to call a foul there, and Pee Wee Brown going to go to the line for two.
These are big-time free throws for the freshman.
Yeah, I mean, he has been in the situation before, though, because every game we've played has been very close. So, I mean, I would say that he is definitely used to the moment by now. I mean, it's...
And playing at a school like Peoria Emanuel, like he did from high school, Peoria Emanuel is a very good program around here in Central Illinois. So these are not his first clutch free throws.
Yeah, and definitely with the fans not in here, I mean, it's definitely kind of lessens it a little bit, knocks down the first one. Does Pee Wee Brown.
It feels a lot like a practice, right?
Yeah.
Where the coach, he gives you the ball, and you're like, hey, if you miss these, your team's got to run. It kind of feels like that
now. It definitely has that vibe. And it's, the team is now taking a break, and now it's like you got to knock down free throws. If you make it, we can go home. If you miss, or we're running again. Here's Brown. Second one up and good. Clutch free throws there by the freshman. Colhorst going to check back in for Maris.
And now is the time where you do not let guys shoot these threes. It doesn't matter who it is. And
anybody.
We now know that Burst can shoot a three, so you can't just sag off of him.
And they're going to immediately foul. I think that is a smart move there from Lepp, not even letting them shoot the three.
Yeah, and I mean, Owens is probably not the ideal guy to foul there.
No.
But, I mean, at the same time, you don't want to give up a three.
Yeah, you don't want them to tie the game. I mean, the little advantage we can get is the best here, and we're going to bring in Barney here after the second free throw for some rebounding. So Owens at the line for two. First one is good from Owens. And they're going to bring Donnelly out. And then they're going to make sure they get some rebounding down low with Cohorst and Barney. Lepp definitely conducting some, trying to get some box outs correct there. I'm going to make sure you still get the free throw shooter in Zach Owens. Second free throw is good. So just got to get the ball inbounds to somebody. They get it into DeAndre Freeman. Freeman gets fouled immediately. So Freeman now chance to take it to the line and just try to push it to three again.
Yeah. I have a feeling that it's just going to keep – hopefully, ideally, we keep getting these free throws. We make both of these, and then, yep, it's tight. This is a tough game. This is a gritty game.
Yeah, it's definitely – it's a game that's going to be won at the free throw line, so this is the time where you either make them or you miss them, and we have the chance to try to push it to three once again. Freeman, first one is going to be off right. So Barney, or Donnelly, checks back in. Going to take the place of Cohorse. Freeman got one more from the line. Bethel's going to get a sub in here. It's going to be Jenny Griffith.
This does make for an interesting idea, though. It's not a very likely strategy, but missing this intentionally just because the clock starts running immediately. Granted, yeah, it's a one-point game, which usually you don't want to try it in that regard, but it does get the clock running, and there is no way to stop it for the Pilots.
Yeah, second one is good. So 6 seconds left, 86-84. Lincoln holding on to this one. Got to get Travion Cruz in transition. He does give it up. Donnelly about came away with the steal. It's going to be DeHart for the three, and he misses it. Lynx come away with the win. Wow, what a final play there. Lynx hold on. And, I mean, talk about just a good look there from DeHart. Just lucky for the Lynx. I mean, I think his foot might have been on the line as well, so it might have just been a tie. But, I mean, talk about a statement win for the Lynx. I mean, that game couldn't have worked out any better for us. We still survived even with the less than perfect free throw shooting towards the end there.
Yeah, and this is a huge upset. I mean, this is an early upset with Bethel being 13-2 coming into this game, and the Lynx only with one win, and wow.
That's a big statement. Win. I mean, we moved to 2-3 on the year now. We got another game tomorrow. So, I mean, we could easily be .500 coming out of this weekend. I mean, we're right there. I mean, like you said, it's another close game. I'm going to get a little stressed out with these games. we cannot play in a game that's going to be a blowout either way. So, if you're Bethel, I mean, that's – you lost to a good team still. The record does not portray the Lynx very well.
Not at all. Lynx have always stayed in the game, like you said. It'll just be really interesting to see how the Lynx come out tomorrow. This is a huge win. Great for momentum. Great for morale. I can't wait to see what they've got tomorrow.
Yeah, so our next broadcast of Lincoln College basketball will be tomorrow on Saturday when the Lynx take on St. Xavier, the men and women's take on St. Xavier, and that'll be here in Lincoln. Our broadcast will air on LCTV. Broadcast time is at 1 for the women's team and 3 o'clock for the men's team. Lincoln College basketball is brought to you by Growl Chevrolet Buick and Lincoln, your CBD store in Lincoln, and Michelle Bauer, your country financial representative in Lincoln. On behalf of the entire crew and my broadcast partner, Spencer Davis, this is Adam Hoffman thanking you for joining us. Have a great evening.